Om Sri Sai Ram. Today we will discuss the importance of the satsang and what Baba Shirdi Sai Baba said, and Sri Sai Satcharita talks about the importance of the satsang. By listening and reflecting over the stories of the saints, our minds will be purified. And then when we learn about our great Paramaguru Sri Shirdi Sai Nath through studious application and intense contemplation, our minds will be purified. Of course, I mean, we can read about Sai, we can read Sai Satcharita without any passion, but if you read it with some love towards Sai and learn about him, then definitely this mind will be purified. If we surrender to Sai, he will bless us. Thereby, our intent to understand his teachings will ripen. By listening to Guru's teachings and his teachings through satsang, will free all of us from the difficulties of the material world. This is the best way to reach our goals. We have to love our Sai without any second thoughts. Our heart should become the abode of the Sai. So what do we need to do to fill our hearts with love for Sai? We have to recite Sai's name all the time. We have to think about him all the time. We have to understand the gist of the Sai's teachings and try to practice them in our daily life. We have to memorize the Sai's teachings so that we can practice them better. And Sai will bring knowledge of the light into our lives so that we will have a joyful living. This love that we'll be talking about will make us understand Sai even more, because Sai always talks about Shraddha and Shaburi. That means we have to believe in something and we need to have the patience to wait for the opportunity to grow in that. If one needs to stay in this happy state, we need to resort to the satsang. It's so important. Let us offer a prayer to our beloved Sai to give us the blessing to be in the company of satsang. We will also ask Sai to give us the strength to sustain in satsang until we reach our goal. Here we have to think about something very important. The most important thing is the ardent desire. And this desire does not arise without the Guru's grace. Only when the Guru chooses to bless or passes that grace, that desire to listen is awakened. This light will show us the path and will increase the love towards Sai. Bad company is absolutely harmful. I mean, here bad company means it's not really, really terrible company. We're talking about the people who are not interested in the spiritual path, who are not interested in your Guru. It's better to be with the same yoke. That's what Bible also teaches. It is the abode of several miseries, this bad company. Unknowingly, it would take you to the, like a detour in your life. And you will miss the highway of the happiness. Without the one and only Sai Nath, or without our Sadguru, who else can purify the ill effects of the bad company, right? Words spoken by the Guru out of compassion, we have to remember these words retain in your heart and your bad deeds will be washed away. Satsang completely destroys the bodily pride, and so we call that as ego, that is called aham bhavana. Therefore, there is no other means than satsang. It's important to hold on to the good company of the Guru and keep mingling with the virtuous people and we have to disentangle from the worldly ties, which can cause disturbance in our lives. Definitely herein is your fulfillment. We shouldn't have any second thoughts about it. Abandoning the clever, cunning ways to survive in this world, where does it take us? And we have to keep thinking about the satsang all the time. And recall always Sai Sai. Think about your guru all the time. And then you will be able to cross this worldly ocean, and there is no doubt about it. In order to attain final emancipation, the only remedy is to have the detachment of the senses. Unless one has a keen desire for satsang, one cannot realize one's true identity. Happiness is followed by unhappiness, and unhappiness follows happiness. Usually, our human tendency is to welcome happiness and turn away from unhappiness, and it's very human to do that kind of thing. Whether you face happily or turn your back on your destiny, what's going to happen? What it will be like, right? We have to think. We have to search our inner soul and turn our mind inward. But to liberate oneself from both kinds of destined experiences, the company of the saints is the only way. Because of satsang, bodily attachment is destroyed, and that kind of breaks the cycle of birth and death, which is the ultimate goal of life. It is the satsang that gains the treasure of the supreme energy and separates one from the worldly ties immediately. So we learn what Sai Sachrita taught us about the satsang, what Baba taught us about the satsang. It is a general kind of thing. Any Sadguru, any Paramaguru will teach us these things. So keeping that in mind, let's have our quest for satsang. Let's mingle with people who think similar way spiritually like you, so that you maintain your peace and grow spiritually. With that, we will conclude this satsang, and we will talk about some other topics next time. Om Sri Sai Paramatmane Namaha.